for those jurors who really don't know what a cement plant was, could you give them just a thumbnail description of what Penn Dixie Cement plant was?
It was an operating cement plant. We produced cement, which is in the powder form. We shipped out by rail and truck bulk. We bagged cement. We had bagged cement. It was a fairly large facility.
Sir, what asbestos-containing materials do you believe, as a laborer, you're exposed to?
Brakes, gaskets, pumps, asbestos cements, asbestos gloves.
What is a gasket?
A gasket can be in many shapes. It could be rectangle, it could be square, it could be round. It's a piece of material used to separate two pieces of or pipe, or it might be a door and where the door fastens to. When the gaskets were removed from the pieces of equipment, they were pretty much destroyed. Some of them came off with no problems. If they didn't, you had to use some type of tool to get it off. It could be a knife, it could be a putty knife, it could be a screwdriver, and in some cases it was an electric angle grinder with a brush on. After the job was done and the repairmen are gone, we did the cleanup. If the gaskets and stuff were, we would pick up pieces if there were big enough pieces, and then we would have to sweep up and shovel up the rest of it.
And what can you tell me, take the jury back, what would you see when that work was being done by you?
A lot of dust.
And where would that dust be in relation to you?
When you're sweeping it, you're right in the middle of it.
Sir, I now want to turn your attention to brake material. You indicated early in your testimony that you had some exposure to brake materials, and my first question to you is this: how were brakes used at Penn Dixie when you were a laborer?
The brakes that we used were on our overhead cranes.
And can you give me an idea of this brake lining? What do the brake linings look like?
The brake linings were like a moon shape. They were curved. Ours were 7 to 8 inches wide and 9 to 10 inches in length, and they were drilled so that you could put the lining on the shoe with bolts.
How many linings would each crane utilize?
If I remember right, the linings themselves, each brake had four, and I think there were four different places where we had brakes on the crane.
What connection, if any, did you have to those brake linings as a laborer?
As a laborer, we were sent up time to time to clean the cranes up. We would clean around the brakes if there were, and there was always a buildup of dust around the brake area. Cleaned up all of the crane. That area was dusty. The rest of the crane might have rags and stuff that the crane men had just thrown around, and that was our job to housekeeping, clean it up.
And did that cause you to be exposed to asbestos-containing brake dust that was utilized on the linings?
Yes.
And how's that?
Well, we had to either sweep it up or however we were going to clean it up. Most of the time it was swept up. From time to time, it would be used. We'd use an air hose and blow the dust away.
And would you be in the vicinity of that dust?
Yes. The air hose would normally have a pipe attached to it that might be 3 feet long.
I'm going to ask you about asbestos cement. You indicated that you had some exposure to cement as a laborer. And where, if at all, was this material used at Penn Dixie?
It was used on the refractory, which lines the kilns. certain refractory they coated with a like a slurry, and this material came the asbestos cement came in a powder form, and we had a trough that we would mix it in. We added water to it and would mix it with a hose or with a hull. I'm sorry.
This cement material?
Yes.
Where was it applied on?
It was applied to the refractory which lined the kiln.
And do you believe you had any exposure to any asbestos-containing materials that were utilized on these kilns?
Yes. On the kilns themselves, the burner pipe, which is what they use, where your coal came through to fire the kilns, was wrapped with a braided type rope of asbestos.
Why was this asbestos rope used?
It was an insulator to keep the heat from melting the pipe.
And what did this asbestos rope look like?
It was white in color. We had different diameters, inch and a half, I think, and 2 inch.
And how did this asbestos rope come packaged? Did you ever see that while you were a laborer?
Yes.
And could you tell me what you saw?
It came on a spool, reel.
And you testified earlier that at times you had to actually remove that rope material from the burners?
Yes.
And how was that done?
Normally, you could peel it off. Sometimes you couldn't, and you might have to get a crowbar or something if it wouldn't go. But you normally could just unravel it from the pipe.
And when you would unravel it and remove it, what, if anything, would you see?
There was dust in the air.
And where were you in relation to that dust?
Right by it.